Hello, I am Dr. Amos Yav, the inventor of the biphasic calcium sulfate and the CEO of Agma Biomaterials, and I'm very excited today to introduce to you two new products of Ogma. One is the 3D Bond Plus, and the second is the Ogma Shield. These products are going fantastically together. So I'm going to demonstrate what we can do with these two products. The 3D Bond Plus is a pure biphasic calcium sulfate that comes in all-in-one syringe and is intended to be used for socket grafting, for example, in which we inject it to the socket and later on we protect it by the Ogma Shield. So let's see how we can perform socket grafting. In socket grafting, we have two protocols for socket grafting. One is with flap refraction and the other one is without flap refraction. We use the second protocol, that is without flap reflection, in all of those cases that we have a four bony wall sockets. When we have a missing of buccal plate, then we reflect a minimal flap as we shown in our protocols. First, what I need to do is to open the box of the 3D Bond Plus. After extraction and complete debridement, that's the time that I can prepare the 3D Bond Plus. As you can see, it is a smart syringe that contains a shaft, two pistons, a cap, the powder, and a saline solution. Now, when we advance the shaft forward, we place the shaft in the palm of our hand, we advance it slowly. At this stage, the liquid from the first compartment is moving forward to the second compartment in which the powder is located. Now we push it until the first piston reaches the line. Immediately after, by twisting and pulling motion, we remove the cap and approaching to the socket. Now we injecting the content of the syringe into the socket. Immediately after, we take a dry unfolded gauze and press it firmly with our finger for 3 seconds. But it's not enough. Now we remove the finger and use the periostal elevator in order to add additional compaction. It is very important that the material will be well compacted at the cervical level. Again, for 3-4 seconds, no more. At this moment, we finish our socket grafting procedure. However, the bone graft cement cannot be left exposed more than 3 millimeters. If it's exposed more than 3 millimeters, we must protect it with the Ogma Shield. The Ogma Shield is a wound dressing made from polymer that it's almost completely resorbed, but it will provide a sufficient protection until soft tissue proliferation will take place and will bridge the gap between the incision lines. So this is the Ogma Shield. Now we need to adapt it to the socket. So I bend it into half and then cut those 2 triangles from the sides in the middle. I'm opening it and as you can see, it is quite well adapted. One thing is important to know: if you want that the Ogma Shield will adhere better to the soft tissue, is to take a moist gauze and to clean the soft tissue before using the Ogma Shield. Now, what we need to do, we need to detach it from its underlayer and then adapt it to the side. And you can see that it's already stick to the soft tissue. After placing the Ogma Shield, it must be secure in place until soft tissue proliferation will take place and bridge the gap. If we leave the Ogma Shield without securing it by sutures, actually it will fall down after 5-6 hours, which is not enough for us. We need to keep it in place for at least 10-12 days. So we're placing it. You can see that it's adhered to the soft tissue, and now we must secure it by sutures. The technique is quite simple. Below the Ogma Shield, we introduce the needle from the mesial aspect to the distal, and then we go to the palatal aspect from the mesial to the distal and make our knot on top of the ogma shield. So I'm going to show how it is. I'm going from the mesial aspect to the distal, below the ogma shield. And then I'm crossing to the palatal aspect from the mesial to the distal and make my knot on top of the ogma shield. If we feel that we want to make another cross-suturing, of course, it's possible. If we are not sure if it's stable enough, then we add another cross-suturing. After securing the ogma shield, we are leaving it for about 12 days. And we instruct the patient not to do a mouth rinse with salt water, otherwise it will resorb too fast. In about 12 days, we can take the suture out, or if we use a resorbable sutures, we need to use a suture that will last at least 2 weeks. We cannot use a plain or chrome good sutures because they will resorb too fast. So that's what we need to use. Of course, we instruct the patient not to play with it and not to try to take it out or something like that. And that's the end of the demonstration. As you can see, it's very easy and very simple. Thank you.